Welcome to episode 4 of Inside Azure for IT. I'm Erin Chapple, CVP of Azure Core Product and Design. Before we get started, remember, this is part 2 of a 3-part episode. In the first segment, I talked with Jellyfish Pictures about how they create amazing visuals in motion pictures using Azure high-performance computing to accelerate rendering and gain significant efficiencies, so they have more time for the creative process. And in part 3, I'll chat with Volocopter, a pioneer in providing air taxi and drone services in urban environments. They're building a cloud-native solution to integrate with smart cities and existing mobility operations using Azure infrastructure and AI. And in this segment, I'm excited to talk with members of the Azure Quantum team about a project they worked on with Jet Propulsion Laboratory at NASA. We'll discuss how quantum-inspired algorithms help them solve a unique scheduling challenge and how this approach could solve similar challenges in different industries. Before we dive in, I'd like to introduce two people who get to work with some of the most exciting technology at Microsoft. Welcome, Anita Ramanan, Technical Program Manager, Lead for Optimization in Azure Quantum, and Viktor Veis, Azure Quantum Group Software Engineering Manager.
Thanks for having us, Erin.
Thank you. Great to be here.
Now, sometimes the tangible impacts of next-gen technology can be hard to imagine. And with current pressures, most companies are focused on getting through the current challenges. But Azure Quantum represents next-gen tech that can help solve problems today, you know, even those that are too complex for classical computing. Now, Anita, I have to say, we get to work with some really amazing companies, but NASA, wow, I'm so jealous. You know, please help us all feel like we're part of the collaboration and tell us about the project you worked on with NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory.
I'd love to, Erin. I was obsessed with space exploration as a kid, and all I wanted to be was an astronaut. So when this project came along, I could not say yes fast enough. Now, NASA is starting to launch more frequent and more complex missions into space, which can make it challenging to effectively manage communications between us here on Earth and the spacecraft. For this project, we collaborated with the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, or JPL, to explore ways that we could solve that problem with Azure Quantum. For those not familiar with the technology, Azure Quantum brings together the most innovative quantum computing and optimization solutions into a single cloud service. To communicate with space missions, JPL uses something called the Deep Space Network, or DSN. Now, this is basically a global network of radio antennas, which allow constant communication between Earth and the spacecraft as the Earth rotates. Now, as you can imagine, there are quite a few people who want to use the DSN at any one time. And that's not just limited to JPL, but other space agencies outside of NASA worldwide. And with more missions being added all the time, there simply are not enough time slots to accommodate all of these requests. And Viktor can tell us a bit more about that.
That's right. The DSN receives several hundred communication requests each week, and scheduling them efficiently requires a lot of computing resources. In fact, at the beginning of our project, we recorded run times of 2 hours or more to produce a single scheduler. We saw this as a perfect challenge for the application of quantum. Our goal was to accelerate the scheduling process to enable NASA to get more time on the DSN.
You know, 2 hours is a long time to wait for a single schedule. And in fact, that kind of downtime is really frustrating regardless of the business you're in. You know, not only does it limit productivity, but it can also stifle innovation. And in NASA's case, it restricts their ability to communicate with spacecraft, and that reduces the amount of exploration that they can do. In other industries, this type of roadblock might impact supply chains or production development. Now, Viktor, tell us about the approach you took to solve this problem with JPL.
Sure, Erin. Decades of research into quantum computing and optimization methods have led to algorithmic breakthroughs that we can exploit on traditional computers to achieve remarkable results. Quantum-inspired algorithms are classical algorithms that emulate certain quantum processes. They are developed using familiar languages like C++ or Python and run on traditional computing hardware infrastructure, which exists at scale in Azure. Quantum-inspired optimization, therefore, enables quantum acceleration through a specialized quantum emulation, with the full power and scale provided by the Azure cloud.
So this really represents how you can take a best of both approach, exploiting classical and quantum advantages to solve really complex optimizational challenges like this one. Anita, how did this come to life in the custom solution that you then built for JPL?
So we took a two-stage approach with this project. First, we developed a solution using Azure Quantum's off-the-shelf QIO service, which accepts input in a special binary format. Now, this phase of the project actually resulted in us making some significant improvements to the QIO service on the back end, which enabled it to solve much larger problems, such as the one that JPL brought to us. Now, this initial effort resulted in us being able to reduce JPL's problem runtime from hours down to just 16 minutes. We then took this one step further and developed a fully customized solution. And this was tailored specifically to tackle the deep space network scheduling problem. Now, instead of using a binary format for input, this solution instead works with JPL's native data format directly. This enabled us to further optimize the algorithm and to save time on problem encoding and decoding. And as a result, we further reduced that runtime from 16 minutes down to just 2.
Wow, 2 minutes. You know, I can imagine how the impact of that, being able to produce schedules in minutes rather than hours, would really allow JPL to be more agile as missions and demands for communications increase. Now, these kinds of challenges are not unique to space exploration, right? This is something that companies in many industries experience, since scheduling can be a major driver of business and customer impact. For example, in healthcare, if nurses or doctors' shifts aren't scheduled efficiently, patient care is impacted. And in manufacturing, if supply chains aren't scheduled efficiently, materials don't reach their destinations and factories don't produce goods. And as we've all experienced over the past few years, scheduling can have an impact on each of us, ranging from minor inconveniences to major life-impacting events. Now, we've talked a lot about scheduling. Let's talk about the different challenges that Azure Quantum can help people solve.
Sure. I have a great example of how we are applying this technology internally at Microsoft. Recently, we launched the Azure Storage project, which is now in operation across our data centers worldwide. Working on this project, we use quantum-inspired optimization methods to improve load balancing and capacity management in the Azure Storage service, which provides the crucial backbone for so many services in Azure. Applying Azure Quantum has reduced the number of hot clusters by a factor of 4 and the number of support escalations by a factor of 10, as well as improving load uniformity across regions by 8%.
Essentially, what this means is we can get more storage capacity out of our existing data centers. And this is increasingly important as customer needs continue to grow despite the challenges in global supply chains. We have to be able to maximize the performance of our data center so we can continue to deliver on customer expectations.
That's absolutely right, Erin. Azure Quantum is a general purpose tool. And as you touched upon earlier, it can be used to solve problems across any number of different industries. Scheduling, routing, logistics, resource allocation, transportation, these kinds of problems exist in almost any industry that you can think of. This is real commercial scale impact that we can have today with QIO.
This has been great. Anita, Viktor, thank you so much for joining me. I'm looking forward to seeing the innovation from Azure customers using Azure Quantum in the months ahead.
Thank you so much.
It's been great being here. Thank you, Erin.
Don't forget to check out the other segments of this episode of Inside Azure for IT. We'll talk with Jellyfish Pictures about how they're using Azure High Performance Computing. And we'll also chat with Volocopter about how Azure infrastructure and AI are helping them build the future of urban air travel. For all our videos, deep dives, and skilling content, head to azure.com/insideazureforit. And I'll see you next time.